we have a series of slots here bounded by a circular region. At the ends of each slot is a full round fillet. Is it possible to pattern both the slots and the fillets? Let's investigate. For the first half of this discussion, we will be talking about field methods. If you have no interest in these, do feel free to jump to the recommended solution using the timestamp. Let's start by answering an obvious question. Can we use a slot sketch? In this sketch, we have a slot with its ends tangent to a construction circle. The only thing governing the length of the slot is this tangent relation. Let's make a cut with this slot sketch. And create a rectangular pattern. The pattern slots do not adjust their lengths accordingly. This applies to all three compute options. Patterning the slot within the sketch also does not work. So it seems like the pattern command does not respect the tangent relation between the slot and the construction circle. Take note that this is the case even if you put a slot and a circle in two separate sketches. Let's move on to using a rectangular extruder cut with a full round fillet. We have a circle sketch here with a line down the middle. The endpoint of this line has a coincident constraint with the circle. Let's try extruding this line and pattern. Begin the extrude command. Select the thin extrude option and select the sketch line. Adjust the wall thickness. To cut symmetrically across the sketch line, set wall location to center. Let's perform a rectangular pattern on this thin extrude. Will the pattern recognize that the sketch line is coincident with the circle and adjust the length accordingly? Just as in the case of the slot sketch, the answer is no. Unsurprisingly, patterning within the sketch also does not work. The pattern command does not respect the coincident constraint between the sketch line and the circle as the pattern propagates sideways. One thing that we can do is to perform the pattern to exceed that of the circle and patch it back up with an extrude. This is a more brute force way of handling the design, but it does work. Let's perform the full round fillet. Begin the fillet command, set the type to full round fillet, and select the end face. So now the question is, how do we pattern this fillet? In the pattern command, the best we can do is to adjust the spacing to be the same as the rectangular cuts. The repeating fillets simply do not recognize the end faces. The problem is that the end faces were all created at the same time during the patching back process. In other words, they themselves are not a repeating pattern, unlike the rectangular cuts. Another way is to do a split body with the circular sketch. With this circular portion split out, we can perform the rectangular cuts only on the split body. Lastly, combine all bodies together and apply the fillet. This might seem more of an elegant method than the previous one, but the result is the same. The end faces are still not part of a repeating pattern, and the fillets cannot be patterned properly. So far, we have been thinking about extruding from the top. We need to rethink this approach and extrude from the side instead. I first learned about this workflow from Christian Lahome. The link to his video is posted below. I want to thank his generosity in allowing me to present his method here. To perform this extrude, we can make a cross-sectional sketch of the profile on the front plane. This will be just a rectangle, depending on the width of the slot and the thickness of the plate. A simpler way to do this is to draw a line and use the thin extrude. In this example, the front plane bisects the plate in the middle. Let's perform a sketch on the front plane. I will simply draw a line down the middle. The height of this line will be the thickness of the plate. Next, we need a surface to constrain the extrude. I have prepared a circle sketch here on the top. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Extrude. And perform a symmetrical extrude of the circle. The actual distance does not matter here. We just need to make sure that it fully exceeds the thickness of the plate. Activate the Solid tab. Begin the Extrude command and select the Thin Extrude option. Select the sketch line. As we drag the arrow, this produces a thickened cut based on the sketch line. Adjust the thickness and make the cut symmetric about the line by adjusting the wall location to center. In this workflow, the length of the slot is controlled by the extent of the extrude. We will use a circular extruder surface as the stopping face. This allows us to bound the extrude without having to split the plate. For extent type, choose Tool Object and select the surface. The reason we are not doing a symmetrical cut about the front plane is that once you select the Symmetric Direction option, the Tool Object option will no longer be available. Let's confirm and hide the surface. Let's add a full round fillet to this end face. Proceed to do a rectangular pattern. Let's first do a pattern without a fillet. Set the compute option to adjust. Each pattern extrude adjusts its length according to the extent of the circle. The pattern command respects the end condition of each pattern extrude. This is in contrast to the previous method where we extruded from the top down. If you adjust the circle, the pattern adjusts accordingly. Let's go back into the pattern command. We want to add a fillet to the list of features to be patterned. In this case, we can be confident that this will work because the end face of each extrude is controlled by the stopping face, and this end condition is repeatable for each patterned instance of the extrude. So it is reasonable to expect that the pattern command will be able to recognize each end face as a repeatable pattern and apply the fillet accordingly. With objects highlighted, hold down Ctrl and select the fillet from the timeline. We can adjust the circle to see how the slots react. Let's proceed to mirror this across the front plane. Set the type to Features. For objects, we need to select the seed extruder cut, the fillet, and the pattern. Select the front plane as a mirror plane. For the sake of presentation, I've taken the liberty to change certain aspects of Christian's workflow. For a more detailed workflow involving the use of parameters and angle slots, please refer to his video. Hope that this is useful to you.